Welcome back. We have a brief introduction of quality. Now come to how to do robust design. And what is robust design? As I introduced in the previous section, that customers' perception of quality will be related to product cost. That is the reason why I said that the quality will be a difference between the customer's expected performance and the actual performance of the product. Let me give you an example to illustrate how cost will affect the customer's perception of quality. Assume you want to buy an LCD projector. I believe the brightness will be the key performance. Say you have three choices, A, B, and C, and this is the performance, which is the brightness of the projectors. You can see A and C are better than product B. So only look at the performance, you probably will pick either A or C. But as I mentioned, that the performance of a product will vary due to either life cycle or due to manufacturing errors. So there is a tolerance associated with the performance. Therefore, when you consider conformance, you will see product B and C are better than product A. When you want to pick a good projectors, if you consider both performance and conformance, how will you select? It seems product C is the best choice because it has a better performance and a better conformance. But what if I told you this is the price of the projector? Product C is more expensive than product A and B. As I mentioned, that the customer's expectation for the quality will raise related to the cost. Therefore, the product C supposed to deliver better performance and better conformance. So when you consider both price and the performance, you will see that the product C is not 100% the best choice. Product B actually is not that bad, since it's cheaper, although the brightness is not as good, but it has a pretty good conformance. Now the challenge is, can we design a product D which has the best performance and also the best conformance? And they will be better that if the cost will be cheaper. Offline quality engineering propose three stages to improve the quality. First one is concept design. The second one is parameter design. And the last one is tolerance control. And in the first stage, the system design, you map from the functional requirement to system configuration. Assume you want to design a linear mechanism for a CD player. There are many different kinds of possible mechanisms can deliver the same function, either motor lead screw, slider linkage, linear motor, or even hydraulic piston. At this stage, you need to consider which configuration will be best for your design requirement. Or you want to design a spring. They are either spiral spring, leaf spring, cantilever springs. There are different systems that can fulfill the function of spring. At this stage, you need to determine which one is the best. After system design, you need to determine the nominal output for your design. For example, you select the cantilever spring. At this stage, there are several parameters, the length, width, height, or even material. You need to determine the nominal value of these variables. You can either use Taguchi method, and most of the case you need to use design of experiment, and you need to consider a good index for quality by consider both the average output and the conformance. The last one is called tolerance design. As I mentioned, tolerance control is very expensive, so he suggests you use tolerance design only after you have finished the parameter design and minimize the sensitivity of the errors. There will be a trade-off between quality and cost, since most of the case in quality control, you need to invest a higher cost in order to reduce the variability of the variables. So you need to reduce the tolerance, which are sensitivity output, but not sensitive to the cost increase. For those factors, they are not sensitivity output, we can even relax the tolerance in such a way to reduce the cost. And there are some other techniques, feedforward and feedback control as well. How to improve quality without increasing cost is the main issues in this course. They are either first increase features, but increased feature will associate with money. Second is to increase conformance. There are two methods, two approaches to increase conformance. Tolerance control is not a good idea since it will increase the cost. So we will need to reduce error sensitivity. What do I mean by error sensitivity and how to reduce error sensitivities? We will use parameter design. Because most engineering systems is nonlinear, the output sensitivity will be different from places to places, and output sensitivity is not a constant. If we can find a design to fulfill our performance requirement, it will be even better if that design has a low sensitivity to parameters variations. What is parameter design and how reduce the sensitivity will be an effective way to reduce output deviation? Let me use this numerical example to illustrate the concept. Say y is a function of x, and the nominal output will be f of x sub 0. Due to manufacturing errors, environmental errors, and deteriorations, x will not be always at the nominal value. It will deviate from the target. Therefore, the output will have a deviation too. You can use first Taylor expansion to estimate what is the output deviation delta y. Delta y will be the first derivative at the nominal design multiplied by the deviation delta x. It will be higher order, but most of the case we will neglect the higher order terms. So if you want to minimize delta y, the most intuitive way will be reducing delta x. This is called tolerance control, and this is expensive way. Either you need to use better material, higher manufacturing cost, or better machine. So this is not a good idea. But when you look carefully for delta y, it is a function of two parts. This and delta x. This one is the first derivatives, or you can call sensitivity of the output y with respect to the variation of x. So robust design is try to reduce these sensitivity terms. How do we reduce the sensitivity terms? As I mentioned, the system is nonlinear, so we can find a place where the slope at the function is smaller, which means that the parameters will be insensitive to the error of x. Let me give you an example to show how the parameter design will affect the output sensitivities. Say the variation of the design variables will come from three sources, either manufacturing, or deterioration of the components due to wear and fatigue, and the application environments, since you are not sure what is the loading condition. I use this normal distribution to represent the variation of the variable x. If you want to reduce the tolerance, you will be very effective, since the output here will be reduced. But this is a costly way. If you change to another location, x2, even though x2 has the same tolerance, the output deviation is much smaller, since at location 2, it has a smaller sensitivity to the error. in parameter design, we need to find a location where the sensitivity to the error terms is lower. How do we quantify performance and conformance? Let me use this archery context as an example again. Assume you have four players, number one, number two, number three, number four. Who will be the winner? It is very obvious, since it got the highest score. You can quantify the score by the mean and the variation, which is the distribution. So he got the highest average score. Now the problem is, who is the second place? If you only look at the mean output, the average score, number two will have the second highest average score. If you look carefully, you might have some questions. It seems that number three is a very potential player. Why? Although it doesn't have a very good performance, but it has a very good conformance. You need to consider both the mean and the variation. You might think number three could be the second place rather than number two. What is robust design? As I mentioned, a system can be represented as a black box because the system is model is not always available. And the output will be affected by two parts. The first one is control variables, which are the variables that designer can manipulate, can select in such a way to come up to determine the performance. But they will be affected by the noise factors, which is coming from either manufacturing errors, deterioration, or the application environment, which make your output a distribution rather than a fixed number. In robust design optimization, you need to find out the parameter in such a way the output distribution will be more concentrated and fall within the tolerance limits. This is the definition of robust design. It is a robust product or process which is insensitive to the effects of sources of variability. We don't want to eliminate the variability of the control variables. Instead, we find a location using parameter design where it is insensitive to this variability. Let me use this numerical example to illustrate how to select the location for robust design. We need to optimize the average performance, since the output will be a distribution rather than a fixed number. Second, we need to have a consistent performance. Look at the design P and design R. Design P has the smallest nominal output. But when you look at the variation, possible variation due to errors, the output will have a variation like the red shaded line here. It is not a very consistent performance. Instead, if you look at design point R, even though it has the same deviation of variables, the output consistency is much better, as you can see from the blue shaded area. We need to find a location of a design to reduce the effect of these noise factors, since these noise factors will deteriorate the performance. And it's better to do this quality design at the early design stage, since you just need to find the correct location for the parameters, and the cost will not be increased by changing the design location. The challenge is how to use less experimental cycle, lower cost, but still can get a quality design. In this course, we will talk about design of experiment, since most of the case, we need to apply experiment to find out the relationship between control variable X and Y. DOE is a statistical technique. We can organize an experiment in a very efficient way. And we use scientific analysis method to analyze the data in order to get the effect of each control variables. Takuchi method is one of the famous DOE. It's very easy to use. It is very good at experimental design to study how variation will affect your output. And he proposed a quality measure, which is SN ratio, to incorporate both performance mean and deviation. We will talk about the pros and cons of Takuchi methods and how to modify the design of experiment in case you encounter some errors in the verification stage.